Hello everyone and welcome to Moonlight Jewel. My name is Elisa and welcome to the second video of my Sailor Scout series. This time I'll be making Super Sailor Chibi Moon. I was really looking forward to make her, so let's get started! For Chibi Moon, I'm making a hybrid doll by taking a Draculaura head and a Twyla body, so she'll be smaller than Sailor Moon. As always, I start by wiping off her face with pure acetone and remove her hair. Then I repaint Twyla's body with my airbrush to give her a natural skin color. If you want to know exactly how I made this, watch my skin custom tutorial on my channel. Time to re-root her. I used Rasperry Smoothie Nylon here and rooted the part line a bit thicker to be able to create pigtails afterwards. After the rerooting process, I secured the hair with glue inside her head. Now we can paint her face. Before drawing on her face, I sprayed 3 layers of Mr. Super Clear. I tried to give her a super cute look with big eyes and used some blushing and shimmers to make her look very young. The finishing touches are, as always, some pearlescent powders, gloss on her lips, and some highlights in her eyes. I used some white acrylic paint for the white parts of her eyes. Now she needs some hairstyling. I styled Chibi Moon's buns like Black Lady's hair, so if you'd like to know how I made her hair, watch my Black Lady repaint. Then I just curled the ends of her pigtails to make them look fluffy and full. I made the same hair accessories for Chibi Moon as I made for Sailor Moon, so if you'd like to know how I made it, watch my Sailor Moon video. For her bun jewelry, I cut out the typical shapes out of fun foam, glued them together, and finished it up with a red half bead. Chibi Moon's bodysuit is made of white jersey fabric. I cut out the pattern pieces, then sew the upper and lower front and back pieces together. Then, instead of sewing, I'm just gluing all the visible seams, like armholes, leg holes, and the neckline. The armor-like sleeves are made from a pink translucent ribbon. Actually, I don't have a pattern for them. I'm just layering three layers, shape them, secure them with a few stitches, and glue them on the bodysuit. Then I sew the side seams and the crotch seam, put the body onto the doll, and sew her in. I just glue the collar and the ribbon with the pink heart on the bodysuit, and it's done! I made her skirt the same way I made Sailor Moons. For the waistband of Chibi Moon's skirt, I used white and yellow satin ribbon, folded in half and sewed the ends in a little bow. Then I sewed it to the skirt and added the heart-shaped bead as well. Her boots are again some Scara Screams fashion pack boots I cut into shape and painted them pink. The last thing we need to do are giving Chibiusa her hat back and add all the accessories to her hair. Something is still missing. Of course, Chibiusa needs her Luna pea. So I'm creating her by using black polymer clay and adding some ears and the antenna. Then I baked her and began to sketch her face with a white pencil and then painting it on with acrylic paint. I'm adding a silver bead to her antenna and give her a little crescent moon made from golden vinyl. And voila, she's finished. We're finally done. Here she is, my Super Sailor Chibi Moon. I love how she looks with her Luna pea, and she's so cute and small compared to my Super Sailor Moon. What do you like most about her? Do you think she and Sailor Moon look cute together? So, that's it for today. The next doll of this series will be Super Sailor Mercury. I really hope you liked this video, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more custom fun. Thank you so much for watching, and have a beautiful creative day. Bye!